Paragon, we have 14 CMM machines that are connected to Smart Factory in the dashboard. It is in daily use for us. It helps us with a lot of investigative work that we do, knowing what our cells are running, how efficient we're running, any crashes that we have on the floor, letting us know if we need to come out to the cell and help operators with some more training. Real-time benefits for us of Smart Factory would be we don't have to step out into the floor. We know we get real-time data when our machines are unattended. Again, it lets us know what cells or operators are having issues or if it's something to do with our programs, and letting us know in real-time, especially on our off shifts, when nobody's in the building for CMM programming that can step out to the floor and assist. We get those notifications that are really handy too in lifetime real data, so we know if we need to make that phone call in the middle of the night kind of scenario when nobody's here that we have a machine down and we can know what we're stepping into the next day. So that's very helpful for us. Notifications that we get, we definitely use the critical notifications more than anything, especially when it comes to our controller and crashing a machine. Again, more so in the off shifts than we do have during the day, just because, again, we know what we're walking into. We know that we can notify management of what they're walking into as well and how to diagnose the problem when we do get here in the building to assist. We know what parts might be an issue, or if we're producing bad parts, why are we crashing the machines, and where and how to fix the process. So those are very helpful tools when it comes to Smart Factory and the notifications that we can set up and receive.
Yeah, Paragon, we currently have 14 machines connected at our Pierston, Indiana facility. We will be adding more machines in the future. We only have 14 machines. All are connected. We're adding shop floor to our Aurora facility in the very near future. We have 3 machines on order there, and we'll likely add it to our Indianapolis facility before year's end. Currently, the programmers, CMM programmers at our facility, have access to the information. I, as a quality manager, have access to the information. We've also given the information to 2 different supervisors on our shop floor. Those are people responsible for CMMs in their area. So as part of our receiving inspection process, we have 2 CMMs there, soon to be 3. And that supervisor uses the information to determine his workload, determine his staffing, determine how much utilization he's getting off his equipment, especially, in the off shift. We also give information to one of our, we give the information daily to our manager of production for our machining processes. So, and these are places where we're using point of use CMM. Most of our 14 CMMs are actually nestled in the cell on the manufacturing floor, and therefore the same thing applies as it does as final inspect, which is the utilization of our equipment. Are they being staffed? You know, how under, how overutilized is the equipment from a staffing perspective? And what we find is people come from different cells only to use those CMMs if they're underutilized. So with the Smart Factory, we can determine which measurement routine is running where, and either encourage that cross-pollination of going to another CMM or keeping people out of an area where they're not supposed to be running because that cell's already burdened. So I think, you know, that's a huge benefit that we get from the software is we can go, for example, into our cup lock cell and determine who's coming over there from the knee cell and then determine why aren't you using the knee cell CMM. You have one less than 40 feet away from your machines, yet you're walking 160 feet to use this other machine. Why is that? And it just, you know, it's not, we don't use it as a disciplinary tool. We use it as an information tool to decide How is our floor best laid out? How is it not best laid out? What does that CMM doing better than the CMM that's located in their cell? From a quality perspective, we're able to contain and limit, contain product right away and limit investigations based upon that information. So just imagine you have a flight data recorder for every thing that breaks on your production floor relative to CMM. We have that. It's just a matter of knowing when to go back and look at it. How did you convince your leadership to get your data into the cloud? And the answer to that question is very simple. We, at the beginning of our loading of the Smart Factory tool, we brought IT into those conversations early on. And we were very fortunate that our senior IT manager felt important that the cloud data he wasn't opposed to, so I already had a friend at the top there. But more importantly, he asked questions about the ports. Which ports are we going to expose to the outside world? Which ports are we not going to expose to the outside world? And then what is the nature of the transmission of this data? Well, overwhelmingly, it's an outgoing data transmission only in Smart Factory. If you can tell your IT managers that to begin with, they'll start to loosen up on cloud data in general. Because what we commit to today is we unlock one port for Hexagon, and it's in a one-way transmission. Data information cannot come back through that port. So once our IT manager understood that that port is secure, and we watch for it, and we check it frequently, then our firewall's maintained and everything's good. The other realization that our IT manager had, most of our business data was already in the cloud. Now, our intellectual property wasn't in the cloud. It continues not to be. But our business data from a financial standpoint was already being, we were already using cloud tools in our family of companies, so in our network. So once you realize things that are contributing to your paycheck as an employee are already in the cloud, running business data like utilization and measurement routine cycle times, it's a very easy step to get to there. So to me, the trick was getting an IT professional engaged at the very beginning of proof of concept and then having them work through what is the vulnerability and can we control that vulnerability. In the case of Smart Factory, you can't.